on your way, and what's news around the world today.
Some wisdom skills along the way.
Oh, and a song to hum along with and sway.
Get your perfect entertaining start to the day.
At 9 a.m. every weekday morning with
Mahima's
Good Morning Bay.
सभी लोग हमारे दोस्त एक प्यार भरा नमस्कार
नमस्ते
नमस्कार
वनकम
खुशामदी
सलाम अलैकुम
सत्श्रीकाल
मीकंदर की वंदनम
जय स्वामी नारायण
जय श्री कृष्ण
जय जनेंद्र
हमारे इस्माइली भाई बंधुओं को बोलते या अली मदद
मौला अली मदद बोलते हुए सारे फीजी मंदिर को बोल गए नीसा बुला बनजन हम आ गए हैं आपके प्यारे महिमा के द्वारे
Exactly,
Bandhujan. Of course, आज है Thursday and let me tell you, July 9th हो गया Bandhujan. Imagine March 16th, right?
Yes, yes.
We actually went into a shelter in place.
Correct.
Now you might actually have people in your family, your friend circle saying, "Arre, who's keeping track of the days?"
Uh-huh.
If that comes up.
Yeah.
It is not a rhetorical question, Bandhujan.
Yeah.
They generally don't know who's keeping track.
Yeah.
But if you can tell that, yes, the Dehotis are keeping track.
Yes, Bandhujan.
You can say Dehoti Bandhus are keeping track because today is day number 115.
Whoa.
115 days of sheltering in place.
Oh, my God.
I would say thank you. You know why, Faltwani?
Why, Alto?
I think because of that particular sheltering place which is happening here in the Bay Area, right?
Right.
People are very diligently doing it. Okay. Some majority of us are doing it very diligently. Sheltering in place.
True.
That's why kind of, you know, if you look at it, compared to some other places over here, fairly the cases are under control. I don't want to jinx it by talking about it. Compared to other places, right?
Nah.
So, compared to other places, comparatively
okay.
to other parts of U.S. U.S. actually, other parts of U.S. are really, really concerning. In fact,
In California itself, L.A. County, hello.
Yeah, but you know, they did not, right? They were not very diligent. They were not mindful about the whole thing. And that's what I appreciate about the Bay Area. And I want to say thank you to everybody out there who are consciously doing this. And of course, a big shout out going into all the capitalist, mindset as well. Because they all said, okay, you know what? They want to keep their employees happy or safe, rather. And they immediately said everybody work from home.
Right.
So, obviously, what's happening is traffic on the roads is light.
Huh.
People are much more happier because sitting at home, debatable. There's some people actually at home are like, you know, I'm home, that kind of stuff, right? Huh. But anyway, the point I'm making here is, it is different. It's 115 days. We're getting used to a new normal. We'll be probably battling with the virus for another few more months or probably a couple of years or year, I suppose. Is what I'm reading from multiple sources. Even the vaccine gets approved and everything, there are many people in the lead. It does take some time for it to get implemented. Say a year at least is what they're saying. Now, iske baare mein aur jankari milega aapko on a new segment which is coming up in a few minutes. But usse pehle, what I got to do is give you an update on what's happening in the roads because I do understand some of those are actually going back to work. Though it is in a very sheltered, physical distancing kind of atmosphere. They still are getting to work and everything. So, just to give you an update on what's happening in the roads, here is our raste ka haal, which we give you absolutely sustaining.
It's time for the Bandhu Traffic Update. Call us from wherever you are at 408-912-2479.
Bandhujan, 408-912-2479. If you told you're stuck in traffic somewhere, well, the best part is Faltwani, it's Thursday, right?
Right.
There are absolutely no bad incidents report on the traffic road. Absolutely nothing. Except one small thing near Berkeley area where actually the traffic hazard reported on 80 eastbound ramp. That's it. Otherwise, nothing. What has happened?
Absolutely nothing. And then except one thing.
Hey, come on. So what? That's exactly what happened the Supreme Court ruling, right?
What is
they kind of gave him the kick.
Absolutely nothing. Except one thing. How will that be?
That'd be so nice, right?
Yeah. Right.
Exactly what happened in the Supreme Court ruling about Trump's tax returns, right?
Yeah.
They said, yeah. Everything is going to be open. But to a closed firm, we'll not share anything else because jury is involved. Anyway, Supreme Court also can't trust anything right now. You can't trust anything nowadays, Faltwani. My goodness.
Yeah.
Apart from the fact that we can trust our bandhus for sure to be listening right now. Thank you so much for this tuning in right now. And yes, this is the Radio D Horries. Good morning. We're coming to you guys every every Monday to Friday, live on our studios, Barjan, in our studios right here in Studio M. And if you're listening to us in your car, probably you're tuned into a network called 1310 AM, Radio Mirchi 1310 AM, and also 92.9 FM. If you're listening on Facebook, wonderful. We actually are live on Facebook. We have updates going on Facebook as well. Facebook.com/RadioDHotties. And yes, we do have a YouTube channel which you can actually subscribe to later on. Mm-hmm. Go subscribe to Radio DHotties. You actually have all our shows on demand for you guys to go listen and watch actually over there for sure. You might say, why Radio DHotties watching? Are yaar, we are the first people almost 11 years ago started off telling you one thing, that we hum log radio pe picture dikhate hai. Literally hum log radio pe picture dikhate hai. Ghar ja ke check out kijiyega for sure, Manujan. Lekin abhi Manujan, I have to tell you one thing. Yeah, amid COVID and everything, right? Huh. Oh, what's you there? Amid COVID. I'm like Kalidas of Shakespeare philosophies. Amid
Kalidas
COVID.
Kalidas of Shakespeare philosophy, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Like,
what
you know,
you
I take fix Shakespeare in a way. We have saying things, but Kalidas style. Kalidas is Desi, right? Shakespeare is like, you know. What, Faltani? What happened to you? Just because you won, just because you're a gold medalist in Kalidas Sammelan in debate contest does not mean that you got to be doing all the stuff for me, okay?
Alto, be quiet. Why would you talk about all that right now?
Wow, oh my God. Oh, somebody felt very humble. Huh? Oh my God. Humility.
No.
Are you talking about Faltani? He's a gold medalist in Sanskrit debate. But I'm not kidding. Kalidas Sammelan happens worldwide in Ujjain. people come from all kinds of places. Faltani was like,
all kinds of places. Ka matlab kya tera?
All kinds of places, nice places, good places, and very nice places. Well, Manujan, the point is, I'm just trying to, you know, deviate the topic right now. But of course, yeah. I want to tell you guys, but amid COVID, we have to make sure we can keep our sanity.
Right.
How do you do that?
How do you do that?
By sharing love with your family.
That is
get
right.
Get your loved ones together right now, Manujan. If you're at home, you're working right now, listening to us in the back end, I'll tell you what, stop work. Tell your guys on your team to say, hey guys, hold on. I need to go and get myself some coffee or tea. Right?
Yeah, take and a 20-minute break.
Yes, so go find your loved ones. And today, now, on this Ganga Kida, I want you guys to dance, Baranjam, because this Ganga Kida is asking you to Jhoom Barabar Jhoom from the movie Jhoom Barabar Jhoom. Baranjam, title track, picturized Amitabh Bachchan and Shankar Ehsaan like composition. Yeah, yeah. Yes, Vidya Sagar, gold medalist in Sanskrit.
Aja rabba ishke di khol guttiyan, kaate na munafe anmol guttiyan, te lagi jo lagave na lage ashki. Oh, te lagi jo lagave na lage ashki. उड़ती उड़ती अखियों के लड़ गए पैंचे लड़ गए वे गीत लगा के झूम 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 बराबर 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 कहां रब जाने जब लगे जहां सब जाने रब्बा हर चोट मजा देती है जीने की सजा देती है रब्बा झूठी मूठी बातें सुन के गुनगुनाती आंखें सुन के जलावे बुझावे बुझावे जलावे वो है मोमबत्तियां जलावे बुझावे बुझावे जलावे वो मोमबत्तियां ओ उड़ती उड़ती अखियों के लड़ गए पैंचे लड़ गए वे गीत लगा के झूम 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 बराबर झूम बराबर झूम बराबर
फिर तो कोई चेपाई नहीं, अपनी दिल पक्की। बोला बहन, कह रहा था बुला रहे हो।
And of course, another song for you guys from the movie Jhoom Barabar. And of course, Vidya Sagar ji, yes, yes, whatever I said, Faltrani. Vidya Sagar ji is asking a request right now, asking us to make announcements in Sanskrit. Well, Vidya Sagar ji, please, we have other people also who actually are listening to us. Well, actually, most of our talk actually is Sanskrit also, by the way.
Evam va.
Very good. Well, actually, the point is, we actually use a lot of Sanskrit words. In fact, Bollywood, if you say it's not Sanskrit, it is Sanskrit. Many of our Hindi terminologies are come from Sanskrit.
Correct.
You might be surprised, even Urdu actually has a lot of Sanskrit in it. Yes.
Whoa.
He says much more than that. He says Bhavan. Yes, exactly. So I understand very well. Don't worry, we'll slowly get to the point. We don't want to actually impose on people and everything. And the reason why we actually play our slokas at the beginning of the show also is because of itself.
Yes.
Dekha, that's why I said you don't listen to our show every day. Every day we do sloka, which is in Sanskrit anyways.
Yeah.
But the point is, yes, we'll come to that. Vidya Sagar ji, every day will be interesting for you guys. You'll definitely like it.
Yeah.
But Faltrani, now we actually went through the whole Ganega Kida right now.
Correct.
Right? What comes up next is very, very simple, right?
Yeah.
It's going to be our news updates, Brajan. And of course, first of all, we go and see what's happening in the headlines. Headlines mein kaafi saari cheeze hai. Probably we'll share with you guys some news in detail as long as time permits. Now, if you want to catch up in detail about the news we share with you guys on air, please go to our news blog, MediaMahima.com. Once again, that's MediaMahima.com. And lekin abhi ke liye, Brajan, this is what's the headlines for today.
The U.S. Supreme Court allows prosecutor, but not Congress, to get Trump's financial records. U.S. Supreme Court deems half of Oklahoma a Native American reservation. WHO says airborne transmission of the coronavirus can possibly occur during medical procedures only. Exclusive news that's coming out from Reuters, Manjan, is that the U.S. is finalizing federal contract ban for companies that use Huawei and other Chinese products. Wall Street slipped on surging virus cases and undermined recovery hopes. The U.S. Slapped sanctions on four Chinese individuals, including Xinjiang Communist Party head. More on that coming up. Angering China, Australia has suspended the extradition treaty with Hong Kong and has extended visas for Chinese and Hong Kong nationals. India has raised concerns with the United States over the new rules for foreign students. And India again has rejected China's claim over the Galvan Valley. Another round of talks is expected this Friday. Further, India is also assessing legal options in the Kulbhushan Jadhav case, committed to protecting the lives of Indian nationals. So more on all this coming right up.
And of course, Benjamin, right now, let me tell you the news which we are sharing right now. We can read up in detail on our news blog, Media Mahima, as well. So right now, let's get into the news in detail. Let's start off with the corona update. What's happening to the corona updates, Faldrani?
Well, at least 24 states have hit pause on their reopening plans, Altu.
24? Yes. 16 last time I checked. Wow.
Yeah,
24
states right now as U.S. coronavirus cases rocket past 3 million. To add to the tension, distrust between President Trump and his top health officials has boiled to the surface right now, and the president has not attended a meeting of his coronavirus task force. Not attended, listen to this, Aldo, in several months.
Wow.
And the group has started holding sessions outside the White House right now. Things are similarly grim elsewhere. The UK also just unveiled another $37.6 billion coronavirus stimulus package as leaders try to lift the Great Britain out of its worst economic slump in centuries. In Hong Kong, authorities are warning of potential, quote, exponential growth, unquote, in new COVID-19 cases after a surge in local transmissions. It's a big blow to a city which initially was hailed for its quick and effective pandemic response.
Mm-hmm.
Let's tell you what's happening locally, though.
Mm-hmm.
In Santa Clara County, gyms are going to be opening, but will be looking much more different come Monday after the county released specifics on the guidelines for gyms to reopen. There will be no cardio machines allowed. So your those, what do you call that?
Treadmills.
Treadmills and those orbit track
and machines. They won't be
looking. They're not going to be allowed. Ellipticals are not going to be allowed. Bikes are not going to be allowed.
Wow.
Everyone must use face coverings while exercising. And people will only be allowed to attend the gym by appointment.
So like how many people in the gym though? Have they been any specific?
They will have that. They will have those guidelines as to, I don't know if you saw even the gatherings guidelines. Now those of you who are thinking that it's okay to have friends over and have gatherings with the gym, they say if you're not of one household, you are not, it is still prohibited in Santa Clara County for you to have people over at your place.
Oh wow.
Indoors. They say even if you do a back door, the only thing you can do is your backyard gatherings. And even that, you have to have physical distancing requirements of 6 feet between each person.
Wow.
And that's also only allowed if it is absolutely necessary. No singing, no dancing, no talking loudly.
Why not singing?
Because apparently COVID-19 particles travel the most during singing. Because you're singing, you're throwing your voice in your singing.
What if you're singing to a mic?
So they say mics have to be sanitized regularly.
That we do in our studio anyways. Yeah.
But I don't know why they say no singing. I'm not sure.
Probably you can't talk loudly, I suppose.
Yeah, they say no talking loudly, no laughing, no comedy.
Oh my God, really?
Well, they don't say no comedy. Basically, they say that laughing, singing, and all these things actually transmit the virus.
Interesting, okay.
So why don't we just not do anything and just lay in bed and not get up at all?
Who's going to pay us for it?
Yeah, that's true. Well, in many areas within fitness facilities will also be closed. Oh God, including indoor pools, locker rooms, and saunas.
Yeah, I never would go to a gym anyways.
Well, you know, the only reason I would go is for a pool. And they're saying the pools are going to be closed.
Go to the ocean and swim in the ocean.
Oh, thank you.
Why?
No, thank you. Anyway, let's also tell you that some good news that's coming out is that Santa Clara County has published a new online dashboard on Tuesday that will track COVID-19 testing by large healthcare systems and clinics. This dashboard shows the rate and count of tests done by each healthcare system in the past week. Private large healthcare systems were required by June 10th order from the county to provide COVID-19 testing to individuals covered by insurance who are asymptomatic, contacts of confirmed cases, and frontline workers. The June 10th order to implement this requirement was one of the first in the nation. And before this order, many were already making testing available, but some private healthcare systems had been redirecting several of its members to get tested at free county-operated sites that do not charge the patient for insurance, according to Santa Clara County Public Health Department. But right now, your private insurance has to offer you the test if you want it.
Mm-hmm.
So, and this dashboard data will provide data from testing done in Santa Clara County, and it aims to put pressure on private healthcare systems and encourage more testing, which will assist the county's public health department and support those who are infected or may have been exposed, county health officials have said.
Mm-hmm.
Let's go on over to our headlines in some more detail. The U.S. Supreme Court today firmly rejected President Donald Trump's argument for sweeping presidential immunity and ruled that a New York prosecutor can obtain his financial records, but prevented, at least for now, the Democrat-led House of Reps committees from getting similar documents.
You know, sometimes I feel like the SCOTUS and the POTUS are together on this.
Yes, but thankfully, you know, this ruling especially has got me thinking they are playing both sides of the aisle. So yeah. They're saying that you cannot be party-based, partisan politics you cannot do, where you're trying to get his financial records, so appeasing him in a way. And at the same time, they cannot argue against him not providing documents which have been subpoenaed by the legal system themselves.
So you're saying that SCOTUS right now is aligning with POTUS. They rhyme anyways.
Okay, he's in some kind of a mood today. Total rhyming mood.
Well, SCOTUS and POTUS, what to do? POTUS is president of the United States, and then SCOTUS is the Supreme Court of the United States, right?
Well, anyway, that's what happened, Miljan. But both were 7-2 rulings, and the rulings were authored by conservative Chief Justice John Roberts. The court made it clear that a sitting president cannot evade a criminal investigation, ruling that the a subpoena issued to Trump's long-term accounting firm, Mazars LLP, for various financial records need to be turned over to a grand jury as part of a criminal investigation, and that can be enforced. I shared before that the Supreme Court also recognized about half of Oklahoma as a Native American reservation land and overturned a tribe member's rape conviction because the location where the crime was committed should have been considered outside the reach of state criminal law.
Wow.
Yeah. WHO is saying that today they made a statement that the transmission of the novel coronavirus can occur during medical procedures that generate aerosols. The agency said some outbreak reports related to indoor crowded spaces have suggested the possibility of aerosol transmission combined with droplet transmission, such as choir practice, restaurants, and fitness classes. And of course, Manijan, in news from India that we shared a little while ago, India is raising concerns with the United States now about a new immigration order that could force a large number of Indian students to return home, the Foreign Ministry of India has confirmed. U.S. President Donald Trump's administration had issued this new rule that would require all foreign students from remaining in the United States if their universities are not holding in-person classes during the upcoming fall semester because of the coronavirus. We will bring you updates on that right here. Also in the Galvan Valley, India has once again rejected China's claim over the Galvan Valley in eastern Ladakh, even as both sides are expected to hold another round of diplomatic talks on the border row on Friday to thrash out modalities for further de-escalation of tension along the Lakchil line of control. And everybody knows about that person who was imprisoned, right, in Pakistan, the Indian national Kulbushan Jadhav. India is now exploring legal options in this case, he's on death row in Pakistan, Madhijan, and they're assuring that they're committed to protecting the life of this Indian national as well. So more on all these stories you can find on mediamahima.com, Madhijan. We'll be back tonight live at 5 on the Pam Pam Show. Till then, dance along and stay happy, stay healthy, and stay informed, stay connected. Have a terrific Thursday.